stage. I was an outside hitter for Team Canada for 7 years. I want to say thank you for supporting our women's program in their journey to the 2020 Olympics and wish you the best of luck in your upcoming season.
Hey guys, this is Marisa Field coming at you from Santorini, Greece. I played with the senior women's national team as a middle blocker for 11 years. So I just want to say thank you so much for all your support and for helping us on the journey to 2020 Olympics. And best of luck with all your seasons. Thanks a lot.
Hi, Ace Volleyball Club. My name is Megan Sear, and I just wanted to send you a quick video to thank you guys for all the support you provide to our team. It is so appreciated, and I hope that we can make you proud leading up to the 2020 Olympics. And I just wanted to wish the girls good luck in the upcoming season. I hope you guys know that you're a huge inspiration to us and why we play. So good luck, and do your best. Thank you. Bye.
My name is Jessie Nile, connecting the barrel for the senior national team. I just want to thank you so much for supporting our journey to the 2020 Olympics, and I want to wish you best of luck in your upcoming season.
Hi guys, I'm Carla Ritchie. I'm captain of the women's national team. I've been playing on the team for 9 years, and I'm a left side.
And I'm Alicia Perrin, and I've been on the team for 6 years, and I'm a middle blocker. We just want to say thank you guys so much for coming together and supporting our team as we journey through to qualify for Tokyo 2020. We really appreciate all the support that your club has been giving us.
And we're cheering you on for all the best in your club season from Lima, Peru.
Gracias!
Hi, Ace Volleyball. I'm Alyssa Coulter. I'm one of the left sides for Team Canada. I'm also from Calgary. So thank you so much for your support of our journey to 2020, and good luck in your upcoming season.
Hey, Ace Volleyball Club. My name is Jennifer Cross. I am a middle blocker on the senior women's national team, and I'm currently playing overseas in Bulgaria and in Champions League. So I just wanted to say thank you so much for your support towards our goal for Tokyo 2020. It really means a lot, and hopefully will help us achieve our goals in the long run. So I just want to also say good luck this season, and we're supporting you.
Hi, it's Volleyball Club. My name is Brianna Greenish. It is my third year with the women's national team, and I'm currently playing professionally in Switzerland. I just want to say thank you for your support and our goal of reaching the 2020 Olympics, and good luck in your upcoming season.
Hey Ace, it's Danny Smith. I'm center for the senior women's national team. I just wanted to thank you all for all your continued support for us and our dream to go to the 2020 Olympics in Tokyo. And I also wanted to wish you all the best of luck in your upcoming season. Thank you. Bye.
Hi, Ace family. This is Lucy Shrook, middle blocker for the national team. I'm over here playing in Slovenia this season. I just want to take some time to thank you guys so much for all the support you've been giving us. We really appreciate it on our journey towards the Olympics. And mostly I want to say good luck to you all this season.
Now I'm playing at the University of Toronto my final year, Go Blues. I want to thank you so much for your support to our journey to Tokyo 2020, and we really cannot thank you. So enjoy your upcoming season, and best of luck. Bye.
Hi, it's Volleyball Club. My name is Sarah Chase, and I'm an outside hitter with the senior women's national team. I wanted to thank you guys for supporting our journey to the 2020 Olympics. And I hope you have so much fun this club season, and go kill it.
Hi, guys. My name is Cam. I'm a starter on the national team since this summer. I am playing in Germany now for Zul in the first Bundesliga. And I want to thank you so much for supporting the team in our journey to the 2020 Olympics. And I wish you best of luck this season. Ciao.
Hey Ace Volleyball Club, it's Alicia Ogams. I'm a medal blocker with Team Canada. I just wanted to thank you for your support in helping us reach our goal in the 2020 Olympics, and best of luck for your upcoming season.
Hi Ace, my name's Autumn Bailey. I'm an outside hitter for the senior women's national team. I'm currently playing in Turkey. I just wanted to say thank you so much for your support of our team and our journey to the 2020 Olympics in Tokyo. It means a lot to us and we're really grateful. Good luck in your upcoming seasons and thank you so much again.
Hey Ace Volleyball Club, my name is Kristen Monks, one of the liberos for the senior women's national team. I've been a part of the program for about 6 years now and on the senior team for 4 years. I'm going into my third professional season in Finland this week. And I just wanted to thank you guys for your continued support on our road to the 2020 Olympics and wish you the best of luck in your upcoming club season. Thanks, guys.
Good afternoon. I'm Dave Wildman. I am the technical director of Ace Volleyball Club. I founded Ace back in 2012, and we're going into our seventh season. So I'm excited to see what happens in the upcoming months. So congratulations to all the athletes that are a part of this. A lot of things about Ace, we try to, you know, be unique and different about what we do here compared to other clubs. You know, vision, opportunity, culture, family, loyalty, and legacy are all things that we take great pride in, and we want our athletes and our parents to take great pride in that as well. So we're just going to go over a couple things here regarding that. As I said, we started with 12 teams, or 2012, started with three teams. We are at, I think, 29 teams this year. So it's exciting to see the growth. We have a bunch of teams in BC, and we have a bunch of teams in Lethbridge as well. So a big thing that we strive to do is to give back to the communities we serve. For example, we granted a wish for a 16, 17-year-old young girl in Lethbridge to go to New York last year for Make-A-Wish. And we've raised $100,000 for Alberta Children's Hospital. We've raised probably $75,000 for Make-A-Wish in the couple years that we did it. We've done stuff for the food bank, so thank you for everyone who brought food items today. And then we create opportunity to compete for all athletes, and we'll get into that further. Opportunity, athletes. You have an opportunity here to improve. You have an opportunity to compete, okay? You have an opportunity to create a stepping stone for what ACE is in future years. Our first parent meeting was on the courts at Rally Point, and now we're filling, you know, a 600-seat theater. So what you do today really reflects on what happens in the future of club. Club is a pretty cutthroat world, so. As we all know. So to access a wealth of knowledge, we have over 50 coaches in this club, and we work as a family, and we'll talk about that in the upcoming slides. Just because you have one or two coaches on your team, but you have access to everyone. You have access to all the coaches, doesn't matter the division, it doesn't matter the age. I'll be floating around between all the teams, like I always do, but that's something that really you guys should take in, all right? Every coach brings something different, okay? To travel abroad, we'll go over that in a bit too. We have a new program for an ACE travel team this year, and there'll be a slide about that. And then obviously to give back to the community. It's really important on our initiative that life's not all about, you know, winning a volleyball game. It's about the moments, right? And I guarantee you, I can't think back of a certain game, you know, 12, 14 years ago and go, oh, okay, I remember that game, but I remember the moments, okay? Creating a Make-A-Wish, giving opportunity to athletes that are happy to be here. So, culture, we're gonna drive this one home, the flags. We're doing flags again this year, all right? Don't lose them, because they're really bloody expensive, all right? So we're doing flags this year, and we'll have one player from each team come up and grab a flag. This is a symbol. This is something that you want to bring to games. Coaches, if you use this as a, you know, as a prize at the end of practice, completely up to you how you guys use this as a team, but it's basically your pride in the club, your pride in what you're doing as an athlete, and your pride as what your vision is for your team. So it gives us presence on the court. When you walk in and we have those flags, okay, people know who you are, okay? Be bigger than we are. Well, that doesn't really make sense, but all right, it was late when I wrote this, okay? Create an environment you would want to be. That doesn't make sense too. Who proofread this? Create an environment that will sustain time, okay? Again, this comes back to about the athlete. This isn't about parents. This isn't about coaches. This isn't about egos, all right? This is all about you guys. And your parents invest a lot of money for you to be here today, all right? So round of applause for your parents. And I looked outside this morning, and it never fails. It always snows on our parent meeting. Always. So thanks for everyone for driving in. Family, we talk about this a lot. I love it when other clubs copy us on this. And I know I'm live right now. MRU and Dinos, you copy me on this. So I know they're probably watching, too. That's the best part. This club runs on three platforms. parents, players, and coaches. All three have to work together to get to the ultimate goal. Like any family, we have our kinks. We're not the perfect club, all right, parents? So this is all great, and all the lights and the flash and the glamour and all that, we have our kinks, all right? And we work through them. My goal as a technical director is obviously to always be trying to evolve the club and be unique. So the family and the club always comes first over any individual. And this is any individual out of any three of those groups, all right? So, players, if you think you're all that, all right, you're not going to get far in this program, all right? Team player, always, all right? I'm just going to not comment on the other two. So, legacy, what is the most successful sports club in the world? So, what's the most successful sports club in the world? I'm putting you on the spot. Okay, anyone? So it's the New Zealand All Blacks, the rugby team. They have a 92% winning record since 2000, all right? They create culture in their program, and they create a brand. We try to copy that, all right? I read this book. Oh my God, I know that's surprising for a lot of people here, but I read this book, and it's on the All Blacks, and better people make better All Blacks, and I totally stole this from their book. Better people make better Ace Volleyball Club athletes, okay? And that's the truth. Because eventually, when this sport's done, the real world is gonna hit you, all right? And maybe mom and dad will be there to help you out. Or of course they're gonna be, but you're gonna have to fight some battles on your own. So we wanna create better people through sport. And this is the big thing. Leave the jersey in a better place. This is all about you guys creating an environment that more people want to be a part of. And leaving the jersey in a better place is going to be the motto for the 2018 and 19 season. Today's agenda, we're going to go over the executive committee, team introductions, rules and regulations. I know it's snowing out there, I'm gonna speak fast. Guest speakers, Dr. Robinson couldn't make it today, but we got Nick Del Bianco and Fraser McLeod here to speak on different subjects. Our participant manual is pretty in-depth. I'm not gonna even ask for a show of hands who actually read through the whole thing, because I'm sure there's probably only three or four people here that actually read through it all. But reference it, look through it, there's lots of good information in there. If you're a returning athlete, a returning parent, there's not much that's different. But if you're new to the club, there's a lot that you guys can get out of it. So, our executive board, where are they sitting? Where's Troy? Troy's right there. Have a wave. Troy is our president. All right. He deals with major issues. Michelle Porteous. Come on, Michelle, stand up. Don't be shy. Okay, our vice president, she deals with all the equipment, which we'll get to. Kathy Foss, where are you? There you are, okay. Lydia, where are you at? Oh, you gotta stand up, okay. Treasurer, and then Sarah Wildman is also, my wife, is on the board. And thank you for being so patient through this past 6 days. So, it has been a week. Again, technical director. So we have a development committee that really overlooks everything that happens, all the way from U8 all the way to U18. So we have Greg Selecki. Where are you at, Greg? Waving back there. Greg's coaching the U15 Rocky View team. Craig Torrance. Oh, he's done. I'm going to get him. Craig Torrance. Jeff Quick. I saw you. There you are. Right on. And Daryl, right? So a lot of a wealth of knowledge here that goes into the creation of the club, the development of athletes, and the development of coaches. Fundraising and sponsorship committee. Lydia's in charge of that with Kathy and Danette, and Danette's not here. So they take care of the pub night and different initiatives that the club does throughout the season. Not many. This is the fun committee. Sorry, Deb, where are you at? There's our committee head. Thanks, Deb. She just found that out right now. So, and Lydia, Sarah, and Taylor are also on that that committee. So, if an issue arises, there's a group of people that deal with it, and it's not just one person dictating what happens. Equipment committee. Michelle, not as fun as you thought it would be, huh? We got a lot of equipment, so we sign stuff out to teams. You guys as a team are responsible for that equipment throughout the season. Flags, okay. I just don't want to do that right now, so we'll come back to that. Okay, here we go. Actually, no, we will do it. So, let's get a player from Troy, if you can come up here and hand out flags, please. An athlete from Caitlin's U13 team, please come on up. Era's U14 team, please come on up. Lindsay, you're U14. Linda, you're U15. Daryl, you're U15. Craig, you're U16. Craig's not here. Braden, someone from my U16 team, come on up. Penny, Daryl, Jeff, Kevin. Go ahead, Cass. And one of the gentlemen, come on up, from Tyler's boys team. Oh, jeez. Okay, let's get the Foothills teams up here. Michelle, or no, not Michelle, Lisa, Taylor. What's that? You'll get one. Tammy, Tyler, and Alan. One representative, please. And Rocky View. One rep. Let's do it. This is the one time you get to see me dressed up. This doesn't happen very often. Red hat, tracksuit. It's all good. Stay up here. Okay. All our coaches, please stand. All the coaches in the audience. I love these guys. I'm so hard on them, but and they're hard on me. It works both ways. But you guys are truly the heartbeat. I say that every year, and you'll never get thanked enough for what you do. You know, athletes really, these coaches take time away from their families, all right, take time off work. No offense, you know, adults will get this, like taking a vacation day to go to a volleyball tournament is not high on a coach's priority list, but they sacrifice vacation days to be there for you guys. So thank you, coaches, and for all the time and effort you guys put in. Jeff and Linda, come on up. Every year we have coaches that have been here for 3 years or more. We have 10 in here. We want to give you guys the black jacket, so come on up. It's your third year. We go there. Oh, we're going to hug it out? We can hug it out. All right. All the new coaches, come on up. If your name's on the screen, get on up here. Let's go. The water bottles. So every year we have to expand, okay? And these coaches have been at other clubs, other universities, colleges, etc. And somehow I talked them into being here today. So thank you guys. Yeah, no, have at her, okay? All right, so Nick Delbianco, I've known since, what, 2000, 99? So I saw Nick as a player, as an athlete at the school I used to coach at back in BC. And Nick's gone up in the ranks, played on the national team. I'll let you do the honors and explain everything. So come on up here, Nick, and go from there.
Hi, I'm Nick. I'm here representing the Athlete Wellness Academy, and we're going to be working with the whole club this season, and we're really excited about that. I'll get into a bit of my story in a little bit, but first, let me just go through the founders, so myself and Misha Harris. We're going to look at what makes us different, why we do what we do. We're going to dive into the Championship Habits course, which all of the athletes will be going through this club season. And at the end, later on, I'll be sticking around for any questions. So first, there I am.
I changed the photo.
Yeah. It's a different photo than I sent, but. So as Dave said, I used to play on the national team for the indoor and the beach. I played professionally the past three seasons in Germany, France, and Switzerland. I just finished my volleyball career last April with a championship win in Switzerland. And now I've started this company with myself and Misha Harris, who you'll see in a second here. We are extremely passionate about what we do, and we'll get into a little bit of my why later on, but let's first meet Misha. He is a former national team beach volleyball coach and athlete, and now he's a holistic performance coach. He's a holistic health coach, kinesiologist, fascial stretch therapist, and my relationship with Misha has kind of been, we've gone through a bunch together. He's been my personal trainer, my health coach, my mentor, my national team beach volleyball coach, and our relationship started when I was 15, and now I'm 26. So we've been working together in some capacity for the past 11 years, and now we've decided to join up. So can this go up a little bit?
What's that?
Can this go up a little bit?
Yeah. Also. Yeah. Yeah. Why don't you just take it off the? There you go. Oh, you need that. Oh, okay.
Good? Yeah, that's good. All right. I feel like I'm pushing over. Thanks.
I mean it.
Yeah, and so Misha, his passion lies in empowering people to live healthier lives and do more of what makes them happy. And he uses a holistic lens to educate on the continuum of health and performance. He helps athletes restore their health and people struggling with pain to regain their full potential. So that's our background. And now we're gonna get into what makes us different. So first, we have a belief that wellness is a foundation for sustainable peak performance. And this may sound complex, but it's extremely simple. If you're injured, you can't perform well. If you're exhausted, you can't perform well. If you lack motivation, you can't perform well. We keep it simple because it is. We will get into more of the details as we begin to look at the next difference, which is mastering the intangibles. And here we start to dive into six different intangible assets that we've identified as necessary to take your performance to the next level. And they're foundational. So these are performance, mindset, recovery, nourishment, movement quality, and capacity. So we've placed these six intangibles into our holistic performance pyramid. In the holistic performance pyramid, we actually have seven levels, and they build their way up in a specific order, and they start with purpose. So this is an athlete's goals, and more specifically, the why behind the goals. This is a foundation, because without a strong connection to your why, you'll lose that motivation to continue pursuing your goals. And we've all been there as athletes or as in your jobs and you're in school. You can be super motivated and then that can start to taper off. If you can reconnect with that purpose that you set out at the beginning, that motivation can sustain. Next, we have your mindset. And this is right above your purpose, close to the foundation of the pyramid, because without the right mindset, your ability to continually move towards those goals will be hindered. So if you have a goal of improving your passing and you know your why, your purpose, but you're not passing well, and you're telling yourself that, this is what I just tell myself, I suck at passing, I can't do this. Once you can kind of control that mindset and start to move that mindset towards more of a positive performance enhancing one, your performance, everything can move forward. And that's what we want. We don't want you to take big leaps and then drop off. Take big leaps, drop off. We want you to consistently move forward. And that's why these two are at the bottom. Next, we have recovery. And this is something that's often overlooked by both athletes and coaches. And this is one of the biggest parts of what makes an athlete be able to show up each and every day, ready to perform, ready to give their 100% at practice or in a tournament. So this is sleep. This is your post-training, post-tournament recovery. And we really dive into different realms of recovery that you may not have known were good for you or known were doing good things that you can perform better the next day. Then right above recovery, we have nourishment. And this is the food and water you put into your body and the simple jobs that they have, which are to help you recover and to give you energy. Here we go past the classic sport nutrition that you might see from like the sport drink companies. And we try to focus on keeping it simple, and we give you some easy to follow priorities when thinking about how to properly fuel yourself for a day, for a tournament, for a couple days of competition. Next, we have movement quality. And this is your ability to move well so that you can minimize your risk of injury. And when you're not injured, you can play volleyball. And that's when you get better, when you're playing. So if you can spend some time working on your movement quality, we're gonna introduce how to do so. Then you can play volleyball for longer and you can get better at volleyball. And ultimately, that's largely everyone's goal here. So this is also movement quality. Sorry, click next, I'll click back. You didn't see that. So movement quality is also often where many performance models start. They begin with how well you move, working on your movement, then building on it with capacity, then getting into volleyball, getting into your skill. We identify these four below as foundational pieces before you even touch your movement quality. It's important, it's really important to keep you healthy, but if you don't have your goals set, you don't know your why would you show up to practice 5 minutes early to do some injury prevention work? You might do it for a week, but again, we want this consistent, we want this constant, and just as we want your performance consistent and constant. So that's why movement quality shows up near the top. Next, we have capacity. And this is your ability to sustain the demands of a long season. This is your durability in play. Our focus on capacity, it comes in the form of building stability within your newly developed movement quality. So this is where your pre-training protocol will come into play. This protocol, you'll see other university teams, college teams, professional volleyball players all doing this similar pre-training preparation. And it's because it's simple and it's extremely effective. So you're all going to be learning that and going through that, and you're going to see the benefits of that. And at the very top is your skill. And that's where we take a step away and your coaches come in. That's their job. They are extremely good at making you good volleyball players. We're trying to help them out by making you healthy, energized, and motivated, and recovered when you show up to practice, when you show up to tournaments. So that's why we're here, is to assist the coaches in all those areas so that they can then just focus on the skill and making you better volleyball players. So next. So as you build up this foundation, as you build up your purpose, your mindset, your recovery, your nourishment, your foundation gets wider. Okay? As your foundation gets wider, your ability to perform at a higher level increases. So you have more potential for your skill to develop. So that's kind of the importance of our pyramid, our holistic performance pyramid. Next is implementation. So hands up, we're gonna do a little poll here. If you know drinking water will positively benefit your health, performance, and well-being, hands up. Yeah, cool. Hands stay up if you consistently drink 3 to 4 liters of water a day and 1 liter of water per every hour you sweat. Hands stay up. Yeah, significantly less. Some still do it, that's awesome, okay? This is implementation. This is, knowledge doesn't equal change, okay? We give you lots of good information, we give you lots of knowledge, we might expand your knowledge in some different areas, okay? But we give it simple, it's nothing new. And we do that because everyone knows these things. We know that water is good for us. It's gonna help us perform better. Not a whole lot of us do it. Not a whole lot of us do it at a rate that will really benefit us, okay? So that's why we focus on implementation, because we know that knowledge isn't change, it's actually applying that knowledge, which will get you to the next step. And then experience. So, talked a little about Misha, his past, and where he's kind of been at now. He's also working with the youth and junior national teams on a lot of these areas. My experience is as an athlete like you, and I've been going through these different stages for the past 11 years of my career. I can confidently say I was not the tallest on my teams. I didn't jump the highest. I often didn't hit the hardest, yet I was still able to go to Trinity Western, to be on a team that won 2 championships in CIS, to be on the international team, to be on the beach national team, to win the player of the year in my 5th year university, to go and play professionally for 3 years. But I wasn't the biggest, I didn't hit the hardest, I didn't jump the highest. It was these intangible assets that got me to the next level. So if you can take just 10% of this from the course, whatever it is, away, this will help you so much in sport, but also in life. And that's what's really cool about this. All of this is you'll become better athletes, you'll perform better, but you can also transfer all of this over into your life. So there's this, yeah. Okay, championship habits course. This is what all the athletes will be going through. So it's 12 weeks. It's roughly 30 minutes to 1 hour a week. Okay, it's released weekly. So we're gonna set a date and you guys will have access to week one on this date. And then 1 week from then, you'll have access to week 2. So you don't have to sit down and do all 1 hour of the course in one sitting. You can divide it up throughout the week. Okay, coaches, you might wanna have at this practice, I'd like to have you guys done this week. And so kind of having that bit of accountability there would be really good. But we'll have weekly questions to reflect on. You'll have a couple actionable, or some action steps. Okay, that's the implementation piece. We'll teach you, we'll open your eyes to some of the information, but then, like we said before, we'll help you apply it into your day, into your practice, into your life right away. And then that's your homework for the week, is actually applying it. And at six weeks, we'll send an email before then, but at 6 weeks, we're going to do an online webinar, and we're going to invite all of you to join it and to ask questions and to engage and to ask us to help you further your practice. Okay, so if you're working through mindset stuff, okay, I don't get this about mindset, awesome. We'll help you dive a little bit deeper into it and help you apply it into your practice right away. Okay, so that will be a really cool time for you to take the next step of you're going through the course, you're learning, you're applying, how can I do it better? Come to this webinar. We'll give you guys a link, we'll give you guys a time, show up, ask questions, and further that. Okay, today I'll be sending out an email, or I'll be sending it to Dave, and he'll be sending it out. It'll have the link to the course in it, and you just will go on there, you'll click the link, and you'll go through the instructions, you'll get the course for free, you won't have to pay for anything there, and you can... the date will be set, and you'll start on that date. And we've also partnered with the Daily Athlete. And the Daily Athlete is actually one of my friends, Derek Thiessen, who was one of my teammates at Trinity Western. He's created a Daily Athlete journal, and we've created a journal together to go right along with the course. So this is something that is brand new. If you're interested in it, there'll be a link in the email to purchase it. We'll give you a discounted rate for the first week, and there will be free shipping, everything. But that we'll have more information on the email, on the link for that. But that's something separate, but it goes extremely well with the course because it keeps you accountable with daily actions, daily habits, daily just reflecting. And then it's also really cool because lots of the questions in the course will also be in the journal. You'll have some note pages so that you can be taking notes in that journal and have it all in one place. That's the journal. Awesome. So if you have any questions, please feel free to seek note after once this is done. I'll be sticking around. I do have a bus to catch after to go back to Edmonton. But I'll be sticking around until roughly 3:15. And yeah, athletes, parents, coaches, whoever it is, please come and ask me questions. I love talking about this stuff, so feel free. Thanks.
Thanks, buddy. Thanks, Nick. Yeah, it's so important. You know, a lot of athletes here talk about, and parents, talk about what's after club. And, you know, Fraser's going to come out here in a sec, talk about recruiting, but, you know, I always state, like, if you're going to play an instrument, you don't just go to band class and play it, right? You got to go home and you practice, and then you go to band class and then you perform, right? And it's the same in sport. You got to be able to go to practice. You got to be able to do the back end work too. If that's dry land training, you know, mental training, all that stuff. You guys got to bring it to the court. So really appreciate it, Nick, and it's a valuable asset to you guys. And, you know, he works with Trinity Western Men's Program, which is the most successful men's program in Canada. So a lot of good things there. Dr. Robinson was going to be here. Unfortunately, he's sick today. But he spoke last year at the meeting. He's our chiro and everyone at his office. So obviously he's a supporter of ACE, and we recommend if any athletes are looking for rehabilitation that, you know, check out Power Health Chinook. Oh, the fun one. This is great. All right. Everyone's paying attention, right? Playing time. This is club volleyball. This is not school volleyball. Okay. Every school's different. There are some fine lines in between even playing time and fair playing time. And then, of course, there's no such thing, okay? So at U12, U13, and U14, it's even playing time. That means coaches cannot make subs. no matter how good or bad it gets, if you're crushing a team 23-0, it is what it is. And that can go in reverse roles, obviously. So at U15, it's fair playing time. Parents, it's not even, it's fair, okay? Coaches have all the power to make substitutions after 15 points. Does your daughter or son get, the boys are U17, 18, but does your daughter get subbed off at 15? Who knows? Okay? So I'm telling you right now, all right, it's fair. Coaches have the green light. We're here to compete at whatever level that team's competing at, but we're here to compete nevertheless. All right, third set. If a team goes three, you're there to win that game at that point. All right, well, I mean, you're there to win the game from point one, but if it gets to three, I mean, it's pretty common sense that the coach is going to put their in what they think is the starting six on, or the most competitive for that day, or, you know, who's on fire and who's not, type of thing. So could it be the same six all season? Could be. Okay. All right. Are you going to be up there in the crowd pissed off? Possibly. Okay. But you heard it here right now. All right. Coaches have the green light. We're here to compete. At U16, 18, you've done enough years of club, guys. All right. No such thing. Okay. Can players be benched? Sure, they can be benched. Do they miss a bunch of practices? There's so many different factors that come into it. Were they late to the game? Did they show up late? Were they not being a team player and they, you know, weren't with the team during game breaks and stuff like that? I mean, there's a lot of factors that come into that. And I'm just going to backtrack to the U15 and 14, okay? Just because it's even and fair, if a player misses like 10 practices, we're just not putting them on the roster. So we can still bench players at U14 and U15. So don't think that just there's, you know, a free card here because of the age group, all right? And Volleyball Alberta is very aware of this, all right? So make sure you're attending practices. And if you're not, communicate with the coaches. I mean, if you're on a family vacation, we get it. There's more to life than volleyball. But, you know, it's just being transparent here in this meeting, and it's recording. So I can backtrack to this in case a parent wants to fight me on this one. So player conduct, this is all about you guys, okay? You represent Ace, okay? I'm very passionate about Ace, go figure, all right? I care how you represent this name, all right? I'm not gonna read through all this. You signed this form already. You're gonna wear the Ace clothing, okay? You're gonna behave on road trips. You get caught outside the rooms on road trips, you're suspended immediately. If your parents aren't there, we're sending you home on Greyhound, all right? On the parents' dollar, all right? Who's laughing? Who's laughing? Okay. No, we're serious, we'll do it, okay? This has happened once in 7 years, so. Don't roll the dice on this. We take a very hard line with this. Again, teams will be issued equipment. It's the team's job to take care of the equipment. The equipment's expensive, all right? It's expensive to replace, especially those flags, okay? So don't lose those flags. This is the big one. Any outside camps, clinics between the months of December and May must be approved by myself or the board. All right, you're a part of ACE right now. Technically speaking, you should not be going somewhere else. I mean, that says something about us. If you're going somewhere else, to get private coaching. If you want private coaching, we have 52 coaches. Pick one, all right? But if you need to, if there's a camp that's during Christmas and something like that, we get it, just ask. But when we find out the hard way, all right, that doesn't go over well and it goes straight to the disciplinary committee, all right? So parents, if you feel obliged that you need, you know, to go to a camp or clinic during Christmas, just let us know. That's it. And we might be having a national team player here during Christmas anyways, like last year. So, to be determined. Work hard, attendance plus attitude equals playing time. Pretty simple. Did I miss anything on here? Don't consume drugs or alcohol or tobacco or vaping. I mean, that's common sense, guys. All right? Don't get caught. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't have to get caught, right? So, I just know I caught someone in the parking lot vaping last year, so, all right, don't do it. You know who you are. Parent conduct, okay? You know, abide by the rules at AVA. AVA sends so many forms. I'm always pestering people for bloody forms, all right? You know, we want to obviously represent ourselves. Are there bad referees out there? Yes. Will you be upset by their decisions? Yes. Will you be upset based on coaching decisions? Yes. All right, but you're not the coach. So don't try to be the coach. If you want to coach, come talk to me. I'll put you with a team next year. Not your daughters, but I'll put you with a team. All right? No refunds. We start paying for everything basically as of today. All right? I say this every year. Share the scorekeeping. Be the first one down there. I always say that to my teams. Be the first one down there. Then you don't have to learn the score sheet. If you know it's your turn to do scorekeeping, go down there so all you have to do is flip cards or push buttons. Okay? What else? Speaking of coaches on the day of a tournament, yeah, that's not going to go over well. Just warning you, okay? Coaches have to make split decisions, all right? And I will support them 100% of the time, all right? When it comes to play, when it comes to making decisions during gameplay. It's not an easy job. There's a lot of pressure on coaches because obviously we are competing, okay? So, please, players play themselves on the team. Parents play their kids off the team. I like that. Tough crowd. Issues and problems. This is our disciplinary committee. They deal with most of it, all right? You know, if you're an older player, 16 and up type of thing, you know, approach the captain, approach the coach yourself. You've got to be accountable to yourself. You have to be able to stand up for what you guys believe in. All right, and if you think there's an issue, approach the coach. Maybe one of the coaches, you're not very approachable, right? I know Braden is kind of a mean guy sometimes, and he's not very approachable, but he's got assistant coaches that you can approach, all right? Just joking, Braden, all right? If you're a younger athlete, you know, again, we hope that you can do what the U16 and 18s can do, is approach the coach, but if you feel like you want to approach the coach and you want your parent there, that's fine. Totally get it, okay? Bring your parent, but we want the players to speak for themselves, all right? That's what we're teaching here, all right? Be accountable, all right, in your beliefs and stand up for yourself, okay? Players, it's not all, you know, roses and dandelions, all right, playing club, all right? Everyone's in a good mood. Everyone's excited about the club season. Some of you had great school seasons. Some of you had terrible school seasons, and you're just happy to be here. All right, so now it's time to work, okay? So you gotta take the good with the bad. Anything big the disciplinary committee deals with, they work in a kind of a voting way on decisions that are made, so there's no dictator. If it's something extreme where someone's gonna get basically kicked out of the club, it'll go straight to the board, all right, and go from there. We'll take ASAP. Word will take to Ace Athletic Club. Ace Athletic Club doesn't even exist, so good proofreading, Dave. Recruitment. All right, so Fraser McLeod's going to come out, speak about recruitment. This is really important for U16 to U18 U18 athletes, but it's good knowledge for the U13s and U13 to 15s as well. So, Fraser, it's all yours.
So every year, Dave asks me to come out and talk to you, and every year he tells me, no, don't worry about it. So it'll be a parents' meeting. It's in Mount Royal. It's in a small room. It'll be fine. He gets me every year! So, and I'm super happy to be here. I was going to actually talk about this part last, but I want to talk about it first because I hear Dave talking about those flags. So I'm obviously Fraser McLeod. I coach Lee West here in Calgary, the most successful men's program in Calgary history. And we spend a lot of time building our culture. We have one team. We coach one team, one cycle. We coach them for 3 or 4 years, then they graduate, and we do it again. And we've spent 30 years building our culture. And our culture ties to everything we do. I'm up here wearing my gear, not Ace gear, because I'm from Lee West. When you cut me, I bleed black and gold. Because I'm an Akota guy at heart, but right now I'm a Lee West guy. So, very important. He talks about your flag. Our gear is our flag in our gym. Our gear never touches the ground. So if you lose that flag, that ties to your culture. You'll hear some of the same things from me that you'll hear from everybody else in this room, but that culture, that pride, and that trust in your club is what will get you to where you want to be. This club will help you. They will guide you. They will give you a vision. All you have to do is trust. He talks about family. We talk about family. We have an Lee West family. You have an Ace family. You take, and I do this at work all the time. People talk about family, and they say, oh, we're family. No. Everybody's family when things are going well. It's the true test of your family is when you're under pressure. So you have to trust that everybody in this room, every coach that's here, they're here for you. They want to help you. So those flags, I don't want to hear one story about that. I don't want to hear one story about those flags getting lost. I don't want to hear one story about those flags hitting the ground. Because that defines you. It defines this club. And you're this club. All right. Let's talk about recruiting. So, like I said, I'm Fraser McLeod. I coach Lee West. I've spent time coaching the University of Winnipeg State. I have 27 different sets of gear in my closet from places I've coached and or played for. In my career, I've sent over 200 players to the next level. With Elite West, this is my seventh crew of guys. Last six teams have sent, every athlete in our program has been offered a post-secondary scholarship. Every single one. That's work. And it's a process, and I will talk to you about that process. So, first things first, in Canada, here's some of your opportunity as a player. There are between 75 and 100 programs you can go play for in this country. Either in U Sports, which is University, Mount Royal, U of C, Trinity Western, or CCAA, which is Red Deer, I think what else, SAIT. So those, and so there's a program out there for you that will fit academically. If you're female athletes, everybody says you should go to the States. There are 300 schools in the States where you can play. There are also thousands and thousands of athletes, but there are opportunities down south for you to play. So in Canada, your scholarship can range anywhere from $500 to $6,000. It can max out to maximum tuition. In Alberta, you get about $1,800 from the province just for playing post-secondary sports. It's a Jimmy Cogan scholarship, that's already there. But number one of the biggest myths is, if I go play university sports, I'm getting a free ride. Probably not. And also think about the money you spent to get there. So it's about the process, it's about the opportunity. So some of the myths about being recruited. Number one, if you are good, the coaches will come find you. I know every men's coach in this country, and they are super busy, overworked, they have families. They don't have all the time that they would like to have to recruit. They don't have full staffs of guys recruiting for them. At the end of the day in this country, it comes down to you and that coach. So the more information you can give them, the more you can advocate for yourself, the more chance you're gonna have. I'm going to the States, I'm getting free money. I'm getting free education. The number one word I'm gonna repeat over and over again is education. This is a means to an end. So you wanna do whatever it takes to get that degree. And if volleyball is part of that, if volleyball can open that door, take it. But I will tell you right now, everybody in this room will not make money playing volleyball. Ask any coach in this room. We will sacrifice time, but we're not making money doing it. This isn't pro hockey. The third one is, it's about volleyball. I want to play volleyball. Yes, you want to play volleyball. The same way you want to play club, you want to play volleyball in school, all those things. Education. Get that degree. I left school the first time, didn't have a degree. Dropped out. Went and got a job. I went to school to play ball. I picked a school to play ball. Wasn't a fit for me. And as I went through some personal issues, I just left. So then, as a real adult, I had to go back to school to get that degree, which I use never. It's a history degree, it's useless. I got a phys ed degree. I use it when I coach, but the rest of it, but more importantly, I have the piece of paper. All right. So, remember this. You control the things you can control. The stuff that's out of your control, don't worry about it. So, number one, trust this process. Enjoy this process. You will listen to my guys when they come back in the summertime. They always talk about club as the time volleyball was still fun. It's not a job yet. University, it's a job. You got to win every week. Pro, it's a job. Someone's giving you a paycheck. Right now, it's still fun. Enjoy it. Don't keep thinking about what's next. Enjoy this part. Now, going to find yourself a university or college chance, treat that like a job, like you're applying for a job. Because that skill might help you in the future. It's not somebody else's responsibility to find you a job. That's on you. We will help you. We will give you the tools. That's on you. Don't be in grade 12 getting mad at your coach going, oh, my coach didn't make any phone calls for me. My coach didn't sell me. I talked to a parent last week from another team that doesn't play for me. And she's like, well, my kid's really good. And he's very good. But he's got no offers. Who have you talked to? Nobody. Well, who's going to do it for you? Well, I expected my club to call. I'm like, no, man, they're not doing that for you. That's on you, man. You got to own that. If you've done everything, then we'll help you with the rest. And it isn't your coach's job. It isn't your parents' job either. So, how do we do it? There's four things that every coach I've ever met looks for. And only one of these you can't control. That's the first one. Do you pass the smell test? Are you big enough? Do you jump high enough? You might be the best person, the best academic, a great teammate, but if you're a 5'4" middle blocker who can't get their hands above the net, you're probably not getting a job. So, are you big enough? Do you jump high enough? That's number one. Number two is academics. Can you stay eligible for 5 years? If I recruit you, I'm getting nothing out of you in year one anyway, I know that. But if you can't stay eligible after year one, you're useless. Okay, I gotta keep you in school. So write this number down, 80%. If you're pulling down less than 80%, 60% of the schools can't look at you. So handle your stuff in the classroom. Coachability. Every player in this room will say they're coachable. Every parent I've ever met always says, oh, my kid's great, so coachable. Yes, and most of you are very coachable. I've coached about half of you guys. Most of you are very coachable. Except, think about something like this. Well, so first things first. We're recruiting potential. We're not recruiting a finished athlete. We're recruiting potential. So with that coachability, ask yourself, do I ask this question? Or do I say this often? Well, that's not what my club coach says. That's not what my school coach says. I went to a camp and they said this. Trust the process. Trust your coach. And realize that they're looking to see if you can take that next step, which means you're coachable. And the fourth one is character. Your character is defined by your word, by the person you are. And you need to make sure everybody knows that. So, make sure your social media is clean. Make sure your teachers have good things to say about you. Make sure your coaches have good things to say about you. Make sure your teammates like you. Make sure your body language is great. Last time I checked, of those four things I just told you, you can't control how big you are, how high you jump. I've tried, trust me. I've tried every coaching technique there is to make a kid taller. Doesn't work. But you can control academics, coachability, and character. And if you control those three, every coach I've ever met will overlook the first one. Number six, okay. So how? So I've given you all the stuff. I've painted this thing black for you. So let's talk about how you do it. So number one, what you can handle right now, academics. I already talked about it, but academics, what do you want to do in school? First question we ask all of our guys. What do you want to do in school? What program do you want to take? What's your average? How long do you want to spend in school? So once they answer those questions, we start looking at volleyball programs. So start looking at where you want to go to school. For example, if you want to take engineering and your number one choice for volleyball is Mount Royal, those two don't jive because Mount Royal does not offer engineering. So pick your course, then we'll find a team for you. Next one, contact that coach. Send an email. Like I said, treat it like a job. So make yourself a player resume. Where have I played? What have I done? Who are my references? Send an introductory email to that coach. Hi, my name is Fraser McLeod. I play for Lee West. I'm considering coming to your university. I would like to talk to you about that possibility. And with that email, send two links to full game tape. Two. Because they want to see you play. They don't want to see a highlight tape. Because they have no idea how many reps it took to take the highlight tape. For example, I will give you an example that's very topical. When you take a selfie, do you always send it for a selfie? Never. It's like 57 times. This one looked pretty perfect. Same idea. Coach knows that you may have hit 100 balls, that's the best way. So send the full game tape. They want to see it all. I watch so much stuff that doesn't even involve what they're doing with the ball. Body language, how they are with their teammates. Next one, find some references. When I'm trying to pick a kid to come play for us, I want to talk to his teachers. I want to know how he is in class. I want to know what his coaches think. Start doing the work. So, we've given you some opportunities to do some work outside of the gym. Lifting, taking care of your wellness, taking care of what you eat, taking care of the mental side of it. Do all that. Make sure that there's no question about that. I watched an athlete a couple years ago. He said, well, I want to go to play post-secondary. Came back in the summer, he was 20 pounds heavier, and he couldn't even get through a drill. And he's like, I want to send that tape to the coach. I'm like, we're going to send that tape to the coach. You look terrible in that tape because you're not in shape. So now we have to go do some work, and we'll take care of it. But make sure that you can control, because you can control that. If a kid is lazy, can't control that. As a coach, that's a red flag to me. So, you need to take ownership of this. Your parents aren't going to do it. Coaches aren't going to do it. It's you. You send that email to the coach. You make that follow-up phone call after you send that email. You go to that meeting. Our job at our club is to get you that meeting, is to put you in front of that coach. We send you in the room alone. And the hardest person to keep out of that room is mom and dad. And they always say the same thing. My kid doesn't know what questions to ask. So we hand them a piece of paper. Ask these questions. You got to start advocating for yourself. You need to be the person that communicates to your parents. This is what I think about this coach. You're going to pick a place where you're going to spend 5 years. That's the longest time you'll spend with any coach in your career. So it's got to be on you. Be ready to hear no. Be ready for someone to not get back to you. We tell our guys, pick three schools. Pick your three dream schools, first schools we're going to contact. More than likely, two of those schools aren't going to respond. Or two of those schools don't need them. Then we go down the list. But be okay with them. It's okay. Because you don't need 50 no's. All you need is one yes. Our job is to get you that meeting. Your job is to get in that room. And you're looking for someone you connect with. So how do you pick a school? First, academics. Does it have the program you want? Second, roster. Do they have four players who play your position who are first or second year? If they do, that's a bad place for you. You don't want to go there. They already have your job filled. Do they have four players, fourth or fifth year playing your position? That's somewhere you want to go. But you can ask that question. You ask that coach, what is your plan for me? There's nothing wrong with asking that question because they're going to have that plan. Also, ask the question of, how to word this? Have you built a player like me before? Give me an example of somebody like me you built before. Because the coach will have that example. He will, trust me, I've seen it all at this point. I look at a kid, I go, I know who that is. I met him before. If they develop players, that's fantastic. So, eight. Here's some of the red flags. Huge red flag, social media. I've had the privilege over my career to interview many people in my job. And the first thing I do when I'm sitting there, because I'm on time always, is I look and I just Google their name. All that stuff comes up. All the stupid things you did that you decided to take a picture of and post it on whatever, it's all there. And that is an immediate no. Are you a club jumper? Are you a school jumper? Do you have a whole bunch of gear in your closet? That tells me that maybe you're not committed. Maybe you're not, maybe you didn't find your path and maybe you can't get along with your teammates. You can't find somebody who can speak well of you. So I had a conversation a number of years ago with an athlete. The athlete's like, yeah, I want to play for you. This is going to be awesome. This is great. So I watched him play high school. I didn't like a lot of things I saw, but he's 6'7". He jumped out of the gym. And I'm like, you know, I'll take that risk, right? I talked to his teacher, and I've known that teacher, and she's never once sent a player to my program, and she wants a kid to come play for us. She says to me, she says, Fraze, I can't endorse this kid. He's got character issues, and I just can't. So we didn't take him. And exactly what I thought was going to happen happened to him. Don't lie about how tall you are or how you jump. If you say you're 6'5 and he meets you and you're 6'3, you just lied. And he knows you just lied. Always say you're shorter. I'm 6'2. Wow, the guy looks more like he's 6'4. This guy's awesome. I like this guy. All right. So here's some advice I got for you. First, like I said before, you just enjoy the process. What have you learned during this process? Like what are the lessons you're learning? Because I'll tell you, the lessons you're learning now, they're going to matter later on. Trust your coaches. They will help you with this process. Focus on your education. Live those four pillars. Four we're going to talk about. Smell test, academics, coachability, character. You're trying to find a fit. You're trying to find a school that's a fit for you, that works academically for you, and works volleyball-wise. And use the resources that you've been provided. So, your coaches, your parents, your teachers, your advisors at school, university coaches. There's nothing wrong with calling up the coach of University of Calgary and going for coffee with her and sitting down and just talking to her when you're in grade 10. Saying, hey, you know what? I'd like to know what it's like to play for your program. And athletes. You have coaches, you have athletes, you have people that are around who have gone through the process recently. They will help you through it. But the biggest thing is, don't focus on getting a scholarship. Don't make that your only focus in this sport. Because then you will get to that point when you're standing in that gym in your first year and you're one of 24 athletes and your body's banged up and it's not as glorious as you thought it was. It's actual real work. And you will say, I'm not sure why I did this. Because you were only focused on that one thing. Focus on the process. My goal for every single athlete in our program is not to put them in university or on the national team or playing pro. My goal is to allow them to decide when they're done. It's not some coach telling them, you're done. It's not some doctor saying, you're done. They decide they're done. I had a kid played for 4 years at UBC, going to year five. They needed him. He's a big banger on the left side. And he said, look, I'm not very good in school. I need to spend this next year focusing on academics so I can graduate. If I'm in school for two more years, that cost my parents $40,000. Couldn't be prouder of that kid. Two of my guys played in the Olympics, and I still couldn't be prouder of that kid. He's awesome. Well, thanks. I'm going to repeat it again. You play for ACE, This is your culture. That's your flag. Every single minute you wear it, you respect it because you define it.
He's kind of an intimidating guy. Thanks, Fraser. This season, we are doing something new, and we have a summer travel team, okay? This summer travel team, you know, our U17, 18 teams are traveling down to the States during club season, but we want to offer an opportunity for athletes at the younger ages to travel, and with the depth and size of the club, we don't want to throw it on parents as, you know, where a coach asks, hey, if we have 10 people that want to go, we're going to go. And then, you know, everyone's in their own, you know, situation in life, and parents feel pressure that it's like, oh, I don't want to let my kid down and stuff like that. So we're doing a mixed travel team this year. It's a tryout process. It'll happen in late March. So if you do want to explore the States, it's a totally different type of game down there. You can try out for one of these teams. The process in picking the team, the head coaches will not be head coaches of that age group during club. So a coach can't be biased and be like, I'm going to go coach U16, I coach U16, I'm choosing 11 out of 12 of my players. It'll be a head coach from another age division. There will also be the development committee will be the ones selecting the coaches. The development committee with the head coaches will be the ones choosing the athletes. So it won't be just one coach choosing. So keep your eye out on that. It'll be fun. Phoenix is a great one. You got to check your provincial exams and stuff like that. But Phoenix is, I've done the Phoenix one before, and it's a really fun tournament. Fees, it's all in the manual. I'm not going to get too deep into this, okay? U14 and up, it includes your hotels for ABAs. U13, it doesn't. U13 stay with their parents. I have booked hotels for the entire club. I will put the links on the team pages when I get to it, and parents can reserve their rooms. So I booked for the teams for 14 to 18. Then there's a block of rooms that I booked for parents, first come, first serve. Okay, we usually stay at the Hampton Inn and Suites or the Four Points. This year, I think we're at the Four Points more often than the Hamptons. For the 13s, I reserved a block for the entire team. So you would just go in there and book your room, and usually the price is better than what you get on Expedia and stuff like that. Regarding Nationals hotels, hotel costs are not included. Okay, all right. We have to book through HTG, and we have to book through HTG, and I'm live on camera right now, so I'm going to say really good things about it. So HTG is what Volleyball Canada uses. We have to book through them. It's first come, first serve. I don't know if you're going to get you guys an $89 a night room, or I'm going to get you the Fairmont at $499 a night. First come, first serve. I'm a dork. I sit on my computer. I'm usually the first one. So we're usually getting something pretty decent, but I don't want to undercharge parents, and I don't want to overcharge parents. So hotel costs for Nationals is, and obviously flights are not included in the fee. Uniforms, yeah, common sense, wear your uniforms. White socks, okay. Spandex, black spandex, small logo. For practice, wear whatever you want. You wear tie-dye spandex for all I care. But for games, it's black, okay? Travel protocol, behave. That's number one, all right? There's an expense sheet that we did last year. Take care of your coaches, okay? Coaches are doing this on their own dollar, okay? And their hotels are paid for by the club. But there is a travel expense form that goes out to the team parent. And, you know, if you're going out for pizza, just include the coach in it, all right? If they don't want it, that's their choice and their prerogative.
But usually, you know, parents do like go to Costco or something like that and get a bunch of food for everyone. So take care of your coaches so they don't gripe at me. Away hotels, talked about this already. Yeah, I'm pretty good with this. So I'll send out an email and stuff like that when these links go live so that you guys can go on there and secure your rooms. Nationals, 14's going to Richmond, 15's Edmonton, again, 16's Regina, 17, 18's are going to the U.S., and the boys, potentially Toronto, but they'll talk about that today. All right, roll that video.
Hi, everybody. Doug Reimer, coach of the UBC women's volleyball team from Vancouver. I'm really excited to join the Ace Volleyball Club in April. Looking forward to working with the coaches and the players. And a special shout out to David for organizing this. Thanks very much, and all the best as you head into the holidays.
Gee, thanks, Doug. So Doug Reimer is one of the most successful women's coaches in Canada. He's won multiple CIS national championships. He is coming out for our initiative this year, which is the women's national team. Every year we have an initiative that we try to raise money for. The women's team, again, are extremely underfunded. They're a charitable charity. Volleyball Canada approached us to see if we would want to take a stand to support them to make the 2020 Olympics. So this is just something different than Make-A-Wish and Children's Hospital, and love those organizations, but we're just gonna take a breath and we are gonna do this one for this year. And if you follow them on Instagram, Volleyball Alberta, Volleyball BC, Volleyball Canada, they are in desperate need. So you get a tax receipt, all that stuff. This is up for you guys, athletes. You guys have the opportunity to be a reason why they make the 2020 Olympics, okay? This isn't, hey mom, go to your work and collect donations. This is, you guys have a chance to A, get coached by Doug Reimer, all right, who doesn't ever do this, all right, and help the women's national team that, who knows, there could be players in this room right now that'll be a part of that one day. So if you raise $220, you get invited to the Doug Reimer event on April 17th. So coaches, there's no practices that day. All right, so Doug's flying in, he's coming in, doing an event for you guys, he's doing a coaches clinic for us, and he's flying out. He's in here for less than 48 hours. So the link is on the website, just go straight to acevolleyballclub.ca. Players, don't leave this to the last moment if you wanna be a part of this, all right? Do your part. So I think it's great, and Volleyball Canada's excited, as you guys saw before I came out here, all the national team players from all over the world sent you guys messages. So I think that's really cool that they took time to send those in from really every point around the world. Oh, we're having a parent social. This was fun last year. Parents, this is all about you now. This kind of got a bit sideways. It was fun though. It's at Dixon's Public House. Lydia's gonna be selling tickets for it. It's $10 a ticket. There's some food there and stuff like that. So it's the same setup as last year. If you have silent auction stuff that you'd like to donate, please talk to Lydia, okay? There'll be raffles, 50-50, coaches will be there. Coaches better be there. But we're only selling a maximum of 300 tickets because last year, I'm pretty sure the fire marshal could have came in there and shut that place down. So 300 tickets to be sold. It's a lot of fun. We have a team actually from BC coming that weekend as well, so a bunch of their parents will be there. That were the Seaside Volleyball Club U17 teams coming to town that we're hosting. So yeah, it'll be a lot of fun. So if you need Lydia's the boss on this. So and Troy supposedly Lydia's the boss. Okay, this year we're doing an annual golf tournament. This is after the season. Just giving you guys a heads up on it now. This is not for players. This is for parents and whoever else, sponsors and stuff like that. So again, just something, we booked the time, it's happening. So just take note of that. Important dates, here's some important dates. Write them down, take a picture of the screen, do what you want to do. Practices begin December 3rd. December 21st is the last day of practice, so that's the Friday. So if you practice on weekends, done. It's not happening on the 22nd. The first day back for practices is January 7th, so it gives you that two-week Christmas break. So that's probably your first day back at school anyways. Parent social, experience with Doug Reimer, awards banquet, be at the same place as last time, and then golf tournament, so. Did I do that too fast? You guys still writing that down? All right. I just want to sidetrack here, not on this. The biggest question, and this I get from athletes and parents, the biggest question I get when they come to ACE is this going to be a Div 1 team? All right? And I really want to touch home on the Volleyball Alberta rules. I have never promised an athlete a Div 1 team. I've never promised an athlete a starting position. All right? So I'm speaking for my teams personally. I've never talked to a parent and promised a Div 1 team in ACE. The rules for Volleyball Alberta are so strict that one bad loss can you basically crumble your whole season. These rules need to be modified. They need to be changed. And hopefully next weekend we're going to change some of them at the committee meeting. So when it comes down to it, we have lots of teams. We have six teams at U16, not including Lethbridge. Are all these teams going to be Div 1? No. Are they all going to come third place in an AVA? No. Well, we can't all come third, and we all can't win a medal. All right? So let's, again, these rules were made when there was only two divisions. You were Div 1 or you're Div 2. Based on how big this sport has grown, where certain age groups have like five divisions now. So if you're a Div 1 or Div 2 team, you're competing with the best. If you're a Div 3, you're in the middle of the pack. And if you're Div 4, Div 5, you're in that development stage. And that might not be a bad thing for certain teams and certain athletes, as long as you're competing. All right? I will never frown on a development team winning a Div 4 provincial, right? Because that's good for them. And maybe they go and win a Div 3 the next year, a Div 2 the next year. So, parents, don't lose your minds after the first AVA when you're like, oh my God, I'm Div 4. Because there could be 10 divisions, all right? And just because you're Div 4 doesn't mean you're not Div 1 by the end of the year, all right? So, you guys can start throwing stuff at me on stage now. Apparel, we got some new apparel this year. Socks seem to be the end thing. I'm always a year behind. People want toques this year, I buy hats. So there is some new apparel. Sarah will have order sheets. If parents want to order stuff, you get a free hoodie today. So add it to your order, it's $50. So if you order some new stuff, you get it at a cheap rate because it's mass quantities. Obviously, we want to see ACE athletes and parents and coaches, everyone rocking the gear and the brand. So Sarah will have the forms. They'll probably be up here somewhere. And you can pay through credit card, cash, or check. We're just about done. Whew. Calendar, there's a calendar on the website. I am not going on the calendar and going to put every individual practice on there like I did last year. That was insane. And I'm not doing it this year. I will put, if there's modifications, so maybe a team's practicing in a different location, on this calendar. So if it's blank, you're practicing in where it's stated on your team page. Some practices get shifted. Some gyms are available, all right? So you might be a Foothills team. You might come practice at Smash City on a Friday night just because there's an empty court. And your coach wants to get more training in. There's no extra cost. You just come and use the gym. It's there to be used. Sometimes with schools and stuff that like that we rent, Christmas concerts and stuff like that get in the way of our volleyball. So, forms of communication. There's our phone number. There's our email. Athletes, there's all the social media. You guys can take out your phones now. No, I'm just joking. Okay. I'm surprised. You guys are behaving pretty good here. Okay. And then there's a newsletter that comes out at the start of the month. Just updates on stuff that parents need to know and stuff like that. A lot of information happens on Instagram and Facebook. And regarding social media, as Fraser said, your social media, okay, you got to have it tight knit, all right? Don't do anything stupid. Don't get yourself suspended based on something like that. Hey, look what we're talking about, okay? Players, you're not going to go on there and create your own social media Ace Volleyball team page. It's not going to happen, okay? Don't create your own team page. Other clubs do it. It's unprofessional. It's just a terrible idea, all right? So if you want something posted on social media, send it to us. We'll post it on our social media, okay? Yeah, no players may create a social media page on behalf of the club. Don't get caught doing that. There's nothing good that's going to come of that. Ace Nation Live. So we have a link on our website that will be recording games. Not all the games will be recorded, obviously, because we can't be everywhere at once. But if it goes red, it means you're streaming and you can see whatever game's being played live. So we're going to try to, you know, obviously have as many games live through our website as possible. Sponsors, thank you to our sponsors. We don't have many of them, but the ones that we do, we appreciate it. You guys are awesome. And Hampton Inn & Suites, special shout out to them because every year this hotel sells out and they wait for us before they let Canada West or 403 in there. And I know they're watching, so, okay. Team parents, please, teams, get a parent, okay? Mom or dad, I don't care who it is, one or two, doesn't matter, need a team parent. That team parent contact info has to go to Troy, okay? There will be stuff that we will be sending directly to team parents. Every team must have a team parent. So coaches, please get one, all right? The coaches will not be a contact, okay, for those matters. So if we can figure that out by the end of the day, that would be great. That's about it. Team meetings. Oh, we're just about done. So we're going to have team meetings right now. So we're going to spread out either out in the foyer. For my personal team, my U16s will meet over here. My U18s will meet over there. And coaches, find a spot. Go up in the rafters. Go wherever. Don't go behind the stage. Discuss whatever you have to discuss for the upcoming season. Welcome to the family, and let's have a great season. Okay, thanks, guys. One last thing. Sorry. Draw a name. Just one. Okay. No one's going to hear you. Okay. Yeah. Eeyore, come on up. You know who you are. Cassidy. All right. All right, you guys can go now. We're bringing food.